All right, everyone. 1.12 is out now. You guys should have noticed that there was an update for the game. And when you do log into Raid Shadow Legends, you'll see a red dot on the left-hand side of your screen. That's going to be for the news section. And of course, right here, we have this post, huge feature update, V1.12, with a comprehensive list of all the stuff that was in patch 1.12. So what I wanted to do today is just go through a list of things that you guys are going to want to do first. Like right now, right after the update released, really quickly, just go through a rundown of things that you guys are going to want to log into the game and get done. So with that being said, let's start off this list right here with number one, which is going to be very important, not directly tied to the update, but still something you're going to want to do right now, especially considering Plarium just ended up sending us a bunch of compensation rewards, and that is going to be to check your mailbox. It's really easy to accidentally forget this stuff. I've done it before. I know the game does remind you, but it's really easy to just kind of ignore those reminders and then just completely forget about it. And considering that these things don't really last in the mailbox for too long, definitely make sure that you guys double check. Keep it in mind, if you don't want to use it right this second, just know that these rewards do expire in approximately 2 days. We were actually given it looks like 2 sets of rewards here. So we were given the raid update gifts, which were arena tokens, an energy refill, and a clan boss key that you can actually claim instead of the ones that were sent directly to you. I know we also got some of those, but the ones that you can claim are always nice. And we also got some compensation for downtime. I don't know exactly if it was for the update or if there was a crash or something, but we also ended up getting a double experience boost for a day and an additional 250 energy. So keep in mind that these are probably in your mailbox right now if you haven't claimed them. And if you aren't going to get them right now, at least make sure that you end up getting them before they expire in a couple of days here. So there is also an announcement at the top above the huge feature update saying that we did get some goodies in our mailbox. So make sure you guys do that. So that's gonna be number one on the list, first of all. And now we can actually dive into some more update related stuff that you're going to want to do. So number two on the list is go and check your champions. Go through your entire list of champions, all the ones that you have, especially the ones that you might have put resources into leveling up or ranking up, and see if one of those champions is on the list of champions that did get rebalanced. Now, this list you can also find in the news updates and huge feature update. If you scroll down, I believe it's at the bottom here is where they actually get into the champion rebalances. So I'll just read off the names of the champions really quickly, not the actual buffs themselves or the reworks. I know there were actually a couple of nerfs, but the champions that got rebalanced are Bloodgorged, Lugin the Steadfast, Sithalia, Soulless, Warmother, Bloodfeather, Excruciator, Grimskin, Hexia, and Rhinebeast. So if you have any of those champions, make sure to actually open up the game and take a look at what exactly happens to their skills, how they were rebalanced, and it might actually be worth taking another look at them. So definitely make sure that you have that in the back of your head when it comes to future champions that you might want to end up working on. So that is going to end up being number two on the list. Now let's move on to number three. Now this is a really big one, especially when it comes to quality of life, and that is all the extra space that we got. Now we got 200 free artifact slots. Now if you actually go in-game, let me just claim this free mystery shard so the red dot goes away really quickly. If you go in-game to the artifacts, you'll see that if you open up the artifacts tab, it's now, instead of out of 500, it's at 700. You don't have to pay any silver or any gems for this. It's just free space. That's really nice for me because I know that I still have a bunch of artifacts sitting in my mailbox because I was doing a bunch of farming for the tournaments earlier, and that you don't have to worry about in terms of paying. Now, unfortunately, when it comes to the vault storage, we do have an additional 100 champion vault storage available, but this one is not going to be free. Now, if you do want to unlock it, it's going to be in your actual champion vaults. And if you scroll down to the bottom, you're going to be able to click this button right here. And as you can see, I'm at 200 right now. I haven't upgraded anything yet, but to get 10 additional slots, this isn't all 100. This is just going to be 10 at a time. So you guys can see that this is not going to be cheap. It's going to be very expensive both routes. Whether you decide to pick silver or gems, this is going to be expensive either way. So increase your vault capacity by 10 slots, 6,250,000 silver versus 245 gems. So 10 slots, you're gonna have to do this 10 times if you want to unlock all the vault space. and it's going to be pricey no matter how you look at it. Now, I know there's going to be some people who ask the question, what do you think is better, silver or gems? And if you break down the math, it actually seems like the gems is not really too bad of an option. But if you are somebody who 100% wants to save gems for other things, like the Mastery Scrolls update, which we actually just got, I'll talk about that in a little bit more detail in a second. Or if you want to save them for energy refills specifically or other things, if you're limited on gems, the silver is another option. It feels like the cost effectiveness of the gems, it's not really too bad right now in comparison to the silver, but I would say, depending on what your goals are in game, both options are honestly probably okay with this. Me personally, because I have a whole bunch of gems, I mean, I guess I also have a whole bunch of silver, but I'm probably going to go with the gems, but I might still end up changing my mind. I really am going to think about this for a little bit more because it is going to end up being a lot of gems or silver either way, no matter how you decide to upgrade your vault, if you do want to end up going for all 300 slots. So that is available, although a bit more expensive than I anticipated. So that's going to be number three. Now we move on to number four. So going back to actual champions, definitely make sure to look at them to see if any of them ended up getting rebalanced, but also Faction Wars. Now, Faction Wars did get rebalanced as well. Now, I know that I personally, for the longest time, have gotten into the routine of just farming the difficulties of Faction Wars that I can do. Some of them I can only end up doing a couple of stages. Some of them I can get down to, you know, stage 7, stage 8, stage 9. But I've just gotten into the routine of farming the earlier stages for so long now. Definitely try to start breaking out of that routine now if you can, because they did end up rebalancing Faction Wars. It is easier from what I've heard. Once again, it's not a complete walk in the park. They even said this in the patch notes. It wouldn't be completely easy, but it is easier than it was before. So if you guys were really close to beating certain stages, but you weren't able to before, you'll probably be able to do that. And now is a really good time to use those keys to actually try to at least progress forward a little bit if you can, instead of just farming old content. Not only is that going to give you these special rewards, skill books, higher level glyphs, but also you'll be able to continue working on the one-time rewards for Faction Wars, which have kind of been forgotten about for a long time because of how difficult Faction Wars has been. So that's definitely something else you're going to want to jump into now with 1.12 being released. So that is going to end up being number four on the list. Now moving on to number five, the big one, the Nightmare Campaign. I haven't talked about this up until this point in the video, and I haven't talked about it for a big reason, and that is because the Nightmare Campaign has actually turned out to be a little bit different than I expected. Now, I haven't actually got into farming it or clearing it yet. This is actually pretty much the first time I've logged on since the update came out. I did a couple of little things like read notes and whatnot, but I actually really haven't played the game yet since the update has come out. But I've been reading up. People are saying it is a bit more difficult than I expected. It is more costly than they expected as well. So if you do jump into the Nightmare difficulty, you'll see that it costs 16 energy per run. You do have the possibility, though, of getting 6-star artifacts. Probably going to be a pretty low chance, but at least that's still nice nonetheless. And right now, at this point, I guess the best way to really jump into it and think about it is, from what I've heard, think about the Nightmare Campaign right now kind of like Faction Wars. And by that, I mean work on clearing it, work on progressing it, just for, you know, progress sake, and also getting the one-time rewards, which are available to us as well. But don't feel like you're missing out on a whole bunch right now if you don't completely finish clearing it, finish 3-starring it, and getting to farming stage 12-3 or 12-6 on Nightmare. I've also heard that the energy to experience and silver to energy ratios are not quite as good as people might have expected. So again, if you're still on brutal, or even not on brutal, if you're still on normal or hard, don't really feel too bad if you can't really catch up on Nightmare for a little while. There's still a lot of things that people need to figure out. It's more difficult than expected, and definitely don't feel behind if in a couple of days you're still working on other stuff and you really haven't jumped into getting too far ahead in Nightmare. It's not really that big of a deal. I feel like there's still a lot of things that people have to figure out about it. When it comes to the one-time rewards, still just a little note, be careful when claiming some of these things, especially the experience boosts. I know it's really easy to get carried away and accidentally do it, but I would personally try to save some of these experience boosts for maybe future events, champion training events, stuff like that, because once you click on these experience boosts, they do not get sent to your mailbox. They get activated right away. So keep that in mind. All right, moving on to the next thing in the list, something else that you're probably not going to be too worried about unless you're a super whale. That is the Platinum Tier Arena. This is something that is another feature in the 1.12 update. If you go to the arena, you'll actually be able to see, if you are in Gold 4, you'll be able to see how many points you need in order to get to the Platinum Arena. You'll also see this top players thing here. You'll see it in the tier rewards. And honestly, I'll just say this for everybody, for all players. Most people watching this video and most people who play Raid Shadow Legends are probably not going to be competing for some of the top spots in Platinum Arena. If you are newer to the game, if you're not in Gold 4, if you're not somebody who spends a lot of money on the game, if you don't have a God tier team in Arena, don't really worry about it too much. This is really going to be a super competitive thing for the top end players of the game. So definitely don't feel behind or like you're missing out if you aren't in the Platinum tier. Remember, there's only going to be 300 people in this, so don't really worry about it too much. Kind of keep it in the back of your head. Maybe they'll end up making changes in the future, but if it's not really something you're doing right now, don't really feel like you're missing out on a whole lot of. So thought that I would end up bringing that up. All right, mastery scroll changes. So I have an entire video where I actually end up talking about this, so I'm not really going to go too much into detail on this, because if you guys want to know more about the option, you can now spend 800 gems in order to fully unlock all mastery scrolls on a champion. It's this button right here. You'll see it right next to the actual scroll unlock, get all scrolls, and as you can see, it'll fully max out all of your scrolls for 800 gems. So there is a video from a couple of videos ago on the channel going into the details. Is it worth it? Is it not worth it? Long story short, it's actually really close, depending on what your goals are in the game. I think both options of continuing to farm it the normal way and also purchasing the 800 gems unlock, I think they're both valid options. For newer players, I think the 800 gem unlock is going to be better, because something I neglected to mention in the video is, as a newer player, you're going to have to be working on 5 champions all at once for your mastery. So the scrolls could be divided among any of those 5 champions, which means it's going to take 5 times as long in order to end up getting all the masteries on all those champions. But you do also have to invest 5 times the resources to unlock the scrolls as well. But definitely going to be more enticing to newer players. And if you guys are interested in more details in the numbers behind the 800 gems to fully instantly unlock all masteries, there is an entire video on the channel getting into that in more detail, so feel free to check that out. So that is going to be mastery scrolls. And the last thing that I wanted to end up mentioning in this video, this is actually probably going to be the very first time that I ever talk about this, and I do my best to stay away talking about this stuff, because first of all, I'm not associated with Plarium. I don't really need to do this. It's not like I get anything from having them sell more packs or anything. I also generally think that most packs the game offers are absolute garbage and absolutely not worth the money. This is one of the very rare exceptions where I think there is a very, very reasonable pack available right now. And like I said, unless there is going to be another offer that is like this in the future, I am not going to talk about packs anymore. This is it. They're going to have to match this in terms of how good it is for me to talk about it in a video again. I'm not going to mention any of the other ones. I'm not here to promote their packs. I don't get anything out of this. I'm not associated with Plarium, so it really doesn't benefit me in any way. I don't care whether you guys spend or not, and I really try my best not to talk about this because there's just really no reason to. But this is one of the rare exceptions where there is a fantastic pack available without a doubt. I've been playing since April. I've never seen anything like this before. So if you guys are going to spend for the first time or ever, this is a decent opportunity to do so. 3 ancient shards, a sacred shard, 800 gems, 3 days of experience boost, 1,000 energy, and 1,000 silver, all for $10. Normally, a pack like this would probably end up costing, my guess, around $30 or so. So the $100, don't let that fool you. Don't let any of the packs to fool you. Like I said, this is why I don't talk about it too much, is because there's a lot to get into details. A lot of it is very negative and honestly not something I really want to jump into. Ignore the original price. This would never be $100. Ignore the 90% off. This would, you know, that's not true. This would normally probably be around $30, but for $10, not a terrible deal. If you guys do decide to spend, this is a decent opportunity to do so. But I also won't mention this again unless they offer another deal like this, because I try not to talk about this in my videos. But That's the last thing I wanted to end off this video with. So with that all being said, these are some things you guys are going to want to jump right into and get done first with patch 1.12 being released. So with that all being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you guys did enjoy this video and you want more videos like this in the future, consider subscribing to the channel. Thank you again, everyone, for all the support. Really do appreciate it, everyone. Also, consider liking the video if you want to help out. Only takes about a quick quarter of a second, and it means a whole bunch, so thank you to all of you guys to do that. And if you're interested in more Raid Shadow Legends videos, guides, tutorials, news update videos, all that fun stuff, including that video about masteries, I have over 70 Raid Shadow Legends videos on the channel now. Feel free to check them out, and a couple of them should also be popping up on the screen right about now. Have a great day, everyone. Take care, and until next time, this is Salt of the Salty Guild, signing out.